Two words, agentic workflow. But what is it? And how can you use it to take your application to the next level? Hi, I'm Tiffany, and in this video, we're going to leverage the amazing capabilities of agents by letting an AI take control of a bot in the game Minecraft. We'll then see how agentic workflow can lead the bot to surprising reasoning and decision-making. I don't know what's gonna happen. Let's get started. So, the first thing you need to do is to clone the repo called Amazon Bedrock Minecraft Agent. Also, you can follow the instructions in the README, and also make sure that you are working in the US West 2 region. And go to the model access and enable access to Claude 3 Sonnet and Claude 3 Haiku. Also, you can find the template for the AWS CloudFormation file, where you have all of the configuration for your agents to be deployed. So once that's deployed, you can go back to your console, click on Agent, Minecraft Agent, and from there, you can find the Agent ID and the Agent Alias ID that you will need to copy and paste in your .env config file. So go back to your code, .env config file, and then you can change the agent ID and the agent alias ID there. All right. Also, don't forget to npm install everything so you have all of the dependencies for the game, for the application. And there you go. You can go back to the game. Minecraft. So currently I'm playing the version 1.20.1. Launch the game, and from there you'll be able to create a server. So hit escape, open to LAN, and the port number should be 25565. Enter that and start LAN world. So here you go, you have created your server. Now, if you go back to your code and run npm run start dev, you will be able to see your bot. So here, Rocky in the game. Going back to Minecraft, here we have Rocky. He's right there. And you can chat with Rocky by pressing T to open the chat. And then let's say, for example, hi, Rocky, how are you? And behind the scenes, Claude 3 is answering the question, so we should have an answer like, here you go. I'm doing great, thanks for asking. It's nice to see you. So cool. Okay, but how's it working behind the scenes? Like right now we just have a friend in the game and we can talk to it. But how can we bring this to the next level? Here you can see in the config file, the AWS CloudFormation, that we have the configuration for the agent. And you have action groups, and each action groups has action group executors. So each executor has a name, and they also have a description. So here we have action dig, action is raining. Each of those executor is linked to a function in the source code. Like here, for example, action dig is linked to that function in the code, and it's right there, it's hard-coded. So whenever the bot needs to dig something, it will need to understand that it needs to perform that function in the game. Also, for example, if you ask the bot if it's raining, then it will go here to that function and execute the action is raining function. Now that we can see we have given different building blocks to the bot. We have given different functions, so it gives different capabilities to the bot in the game. If we ask a question like, is it raining, then it will know from the description of the function that it needs to execute that function. For example, if we go back to the game and ask, come here, then the bot needs to understand that it has the different tools in the functions that we gave it to actually perform that action. So it will first need to get my location and second need to move to that location. So here we can see that we have two functions, action get player location and action move to location. And because of the description that we gave it, it's able to understand what those functions are doing. And it needs to know that first, it needs to get my location, get the output from this function, and use it as an input to a second function, which is called move to that location. That's how it looks like in the console. If you go to agent, Minecraft agent, you'll see here that we have all of the different actions that we gave to the bot, so the different capabilities, basically, that the bot has to execute. Here we have action jump with a description, action dig. And the come here example is a nice example of agentic workflow, really. But even more surprising, let's say, for example, that I want to ask something like, let's play hide and seek to the bot. Well, because it's Claude 3 Haiku behind the scenes playing the game, it has been trained on the world's data, so it already knows what the game hide and seek is. I don't need to explain the rules. So it, because it knows what the game is, it can sort of understand what actions it needs to perform to play the game with me. So I just asked, like, let's play hide and seek, and the bot says, sounds fun, I'm ready to hide and seek, like play the game, like go and hide and I'll count. So I'm gonna look for a place where I can hide. Maybe not there, but not too far because I don't want to lose my bot, but right here. And if I say, okay, like I'm ready, the bot will know that it needs to get my location to come to me and to find me. So it says on my way. I can keep hiding though, but yeah, right now, if I go back like to the bot and say like, you found me, the bot understands that it is now Rocky's turn to actually hide and my turn to look for it. So that's pretty amazing because it has an understanding of what's going on and really you can do pretty amazing thing with this. We've only scratched the surface of how powerful agentic workflows can be, but just from this example, we can already understand the unlimited amount of options this can offer. The only limit is your imagination. Check out the description for more information about agents, and if you want to see more fun videos like this one, subscribe to AWS Developers. See ya!